all happen at the zoo. I do believe it.
790 AM, 94.1 FM, KFGO.com, the KFGO mobile app. Follow 790 KFGO on Twitter, like the KFGO Morning Crew on Facebook.
So much excitement. Friday is ZooBoo at Chahinkapa Zoo in Wahpeton. Zoo Director Kathy Diekman joining us now. Hey, Kathy.
Good morning.
Kathy, I want to start off on a little bit of a different question, because I know the ZooBoo is coming up, and I'm thinking of the animals, and I wonder, do they ever get, like, maybe some kind of special treat or something? Our listeners, oh, that's kind of cool. Do the animals, maybe, do they get their own version of a trick-or-treat or a birthday party?
They do. No candy, like no chocolate and things like that, that we keep for our little trick-or-treaters that are coming through on Friday. But the animals do get treats, and they get them on their birthdays, and they get them in between for enrichment. And besides the things they forage through in the morning, like the primates would get, you know, nuts and dried fruit to forage through in their habitats, besides that, we do make special things for them, including 14-layer birthday cakes.
Wow!
14 layers of 14, what?
They're very thin layers, but they're very beautiful layers because they're made with frozen berries, smashed up berries, frozen berries. Then we have a primate-dyed marmoset dye that we can flavor and mash that up for the next one. And then they have browse biscuits that we will grind and mix with honey or molasses, and that could be another layer. So they can get all these beautiful, beautifully colored, little darker colors, but very beautiful colors layered in cakes. And our zookeepers are also, you can consider them a primate pastry chef.
I love that. Do the otters get schmelt?
They do. They do indeed. In fact, they get that for their training about every other day. And there's all sorts of little culinary treats in that zookeeper kitchen. And people can actually tour the kitchen outside of the COVID thing. People can normally go through and tour the zookeeper kitchen. So it's another one of our behind the scenes.
Well, we want to talk about ZooBoo. We're excited. The kids are excited. Parents are excited. Tell us more about ZooBoo, Kathy.
ZooBoo happens always on the 30th, the day before Halloween. And this week, or this year, it's this Friday. And so it's very fun. And we're doing things just a little bit differently, like we did for the host season, Bonnie. You know, people were spread out. And I say this every time we talk, but I have to hand it to people here in the Valley and the tourists who came. People are very courteous to each other and obeyed all of our safety things we had in place. But we are keeping with the guidelines, and it's an outside event. We will be spaced out. The sponsors, now this is a trick-or-treating event, so, you know, there'll be a few animals out, but remember, it's going to be, you know, starts at 4:30 to 7, so most animals will be in because it's going to be cold, but some animals will be out, but it's a trick-or-treating event, and make no mistake about it, the kids will leave with a lot of stuff.
Oh, it is so much fun, and it's safe, and it's socially distanced. Do you have any idea, Kathy, like, if you're going to be expecting more people than usual this year, any feel for that at all?
I don't have a feel for it except for what the season brought. And we thought it was going to be a slower season, and it was a big season for us because we are outside. We're in a community that, you know, we've been safe here in the Valley, abiding by everything. And I think that, you know, people are canceling events because of the spike, and that you've reported on a lot of things. So you're in the know on everything being in the news there. But we are able to keep with the guidelines. We are going to have it because there's so many things that people aren't able to do. So we have people calling, and we see them on the street, and they're saying, oh, please don't take ZooBoo away because we want to do something. So many things are being canceled, of course, with good reason. And we're going to keep it, and it's going to be dress warm. Starts at 4:30. It's a come and go. So you get there and you get in the gates and trick or treat, and then you get to go home and you get to look at all your goodies. Again, gates open at 4:30 this Friday. It's $5 per person. Children must be accompanied by an adult. Doesn't have to be one adult per child, as long as your group of children have an adult with them. And go through the zoo. And it's going to be beautifully decorated. And I just, my favorite part is watching the people look at all the lights and the blow up figures and the 200 jack o' lanterns carved by our FFA.
200. Wow. Yeah. Good for that. I love this, Kathy. It's so exciting in a world that's rather messed up right now. What a fun event for kids of all ages. We should mention, too, I saw your Facebook post. The zoo is closed, but we can do special appointments throughout the fall and winter months going on as well, right?
We sure can, Bonnie. And people just make their appointment because we're there every day. We're caring for those animals every single day. So if you have a group that wants to come through the zoo, give us a call, and we're going to be there for them. And we will have also have regular hours throughout the winter on special holiday weekends with the three-day weekends and things.
Okay.
So we're doing that just to get the fresh air into people's lungs and having a great time.
And if somebody's looking for a unique opportunity, maybe not a large group, but maybe a couple, maybe four, six people, are they still able to do behind-the-scenes tours, Kathy?
Oh, they definitely are. We will, you know, a little bit different this in the wintertime, but there's that opportunity. And I remind everybody too that maybe they want to custom something. Maybe they, you know, maybe it's not listed on our behind the scenes, but they want to, you know, meet and greet the otters, or they wanted to look closer at the North American hoofstock or something like that. We can certainly custom that too. So date night or family day or whatever they want to do, we'll make it happen for you.
You betting in the distance here, think Christmas gifts, think gift certificates, memberships to Chahinkapa Zoo. Go to chahinkapazoo.org. And we should mention your big fundraiser too, Kathy. What, it Tickle My Ribs or something?
Tickle Your Ribs. It comes up on the 20th of November. It's our game show night. We're doing it virtually, but you can order those ribs ahead of time. It comes with trivia for the family. And, of course, our raffle tickets are $20, and there's great prizes. So all happening on November 20th.
Oh, thank you for the reminder on the raffle tickets. I've seen that on social media. I meant to get some, and I got sidetracked. We still have raffle tickets available, you're saying?
We do, all the way up until the 20th of November. You can get them online. You can order your ribs online, or you can call us, and we'll get them to you. So just any way that we can help you get this and have some fun at home with your family, we're going to make it happen.
Kathy, I love that it's been a great season for Chahinkapa Zoo. It wasn't looking like it at the beginning of the season with COVID and all the lockdowns here, but I'm glad things turned around. You had a great season. I hope ZooBoo goes over well. I hope Tickle My Ribs is great. And I hope people are calling you and setting up some private tours as well. Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much. Have a great day and a weekend.
You bet. We'll stay in touch. That's Chahinkapa Zoo Director Kathy Diekman joining us here on the KFGO.